Chapter 11, Light, Shadows and Reflections, Question Answers from Grade 7, Subject Science, Book Curiosity. Let us enhance our learning. Question 1, which of the following are luminous objects? Answer, Pole Star and Sun are luminous objects. Mars, Moon, Venus and Mirror are non-luminous. They reflect light from the Sun. Question 2, match the items in column A with those in column B. Pinhole camera forms an inverted image. Opaque objects blocks light completely. Transparent object, light passes almost completely through it. Shadows, the dark region formed behind the object. So friends, you can match them accordingly. Now let's move forward. Question 3. Sahil, Rekha, Patrick and Kasima are trying to observe the candle flame through the pipe as shown in figure 11.16. This one, who can see the flame? Answer, only the person whose line of sight is straight and aligned with the pipe can see the candle flame. Rekha, her pipe is straight and directly in line with the candle is likely the correct answer. So friends, Rekha can see the candle flame through the pipe because the line of sight is straight. Question 4. Look at the images shown in figure 11.17. This one, and select the correct image showing the shadow formation of the boy. Answer, the boy's shadow is formed based on the light source. If the light is coming from above, the shadow will fall below. If the light comes from the side, the shadow will be cast in the opposite direction. Thus, option D, this one, is the correct image showing the shadow formation of the boy. So friends, as you can see, the sun is here. So shadow is formed here. This is correct. This is wrong. If sun is here, shadow should be formed here. In option B, sun is here, so shadow should be formed here. In option A, as you can see, sun is above the boy, so the shadow should be like this. Question 5. The shadow of a ball is formed on a wall by placing the ball in front of a fixed torch as shown in figure 11.18. This one. In scenario first, this one, the ball is closer to the torch, while in scenario 2, this one, the ball is closer to the wall. Choose the most accurate representation of the shadows formed in both scenarios from the options provided A and B. So friends, these are the options A and B. Answer, in scenario first, the ball is closer to the torch and away from the wall. So the shadow would be large and blurry on the wall. So the correct representation of scenario first will be B. This one, in scenario second, the ball is closer to the wall and away from the torch. So the shadow would be sharp and small. So the correct representation of scenario second will be A. This one. Question 6. Based on figure 11.18, match the position of the torch in column A with the characteristics of the ball's shadow in column B. Answer. If the torch is close to the ball, the shadow would be larger. If the torch is far away, the shadow would be smaller. If the ball is moved from the setup, a bright spot would appear on the screen. If two torches are present in the setup on the left side of the ball, two shadows would appear on the screen. So friends, you can match them accordingly. Now let's move forward. Question 7. Suppose you view the tree shown in figure 11.19. This one. Through a pinhole camera, sketch the outline of the image of the tree formed in the pinhole camera. Answer, the image will be inverted upside down and real seen on the screen inside the pinhole camera. Sketch a tree upside down compared to the original one. So friends, like this, upside down, this should be the image. Question 8. Write your name on a piece of paper and hold it in front of a plain mirror such that the paper is parallel to the mirror. Sketch the image. What difference do you notice? Explain the reason for the difference. Answer, when you write your name and hold it in front of a plain mirror, the letters appear reversed, left becomes right. This is due to lateral inversion. Question 9. Measure the length of your shadow at 9 a.m., 12 p.m. and 4 p.m. with the help of your friend. Write down your observations. First, at which of the given times is your shadow the shortest? Answer, The shortest shadow is at 12 p.m. noon. Second, why do you think this happens? Answer, this is because the sun is directly overhead, so light falls almost vertically, forming a small shadow. Question 10. On the basis of following statements, choose the correct option. Statement A. Image formed by a plane mirror is literally inverted. Statement B. Images of alphabets T and O appear identical to themselves in a plane mirror. First, both statements are true. Second, both statements are false. Third, statement A is true, but statement B is false. Fourth, statement A is false, but statement B is true. Answer, statement A, true. Plane mirror shows lateral inversion. Statement B, true. Only symmetrical letters like O, A, M, T look similar. Correct option, first, both statements are true. Question 11. Suppose you are given a tube of the shape shown in the figure 11.20, this one, and two plane mirrors smaller than the diameter of the tube. Can this tube be used to make a periscope? If yes, mark where you will fix the plane mirrors. Answer, yes, the tube can be used to make a periscope. Fix one mirror at the top, 45 degree facing downward, here, and one at the bottom, 45 degree facing upward on opposite walls of the Z tube. So second mirror comes here. This way, light reflects twice and reaches the eye. First reflection here and second reflection here. Question 12. We do not see the shadow on the ground of a bird flying high in the sky. However, the shadow is seen on the ground when the bird swoops near the ground. Think and explain why it is so. Answer, a bird flying high is too far from the ground. The light spreads over a large area and the shadow becomes too faint or dispersed to be noticed. When the bird flies closer to the ground, the shadow is clearly visible. Next, exploratory projects. Question 1. Have you ever seen a firefly where you live? If no, ask your elders if fireflies were seen earlier in your region. If yes, find out the reasons for their not being seen anymore. Develop a story about it. Answer, I have not seen fireflies recently. My grandparents told me that earlier, many fireflies used to glow during monsoons. Now, due to light pollution, cutting of trees, and city development, fireflies are rarely seen. Short story, The Last Firefly. Ravi went to his grandparents' village for the summer holidays. One evening, he saw a tiny glowing light near a tree. Surprised, he asked, "What is that?" His grandfather smiled, "It's a firefly. When I was young, the fields used to glow with hundreds of them, but now they are almost gone." "Why?" Ravi asked. "Because of too many lights, cutting of trees and pollution," replied his grandmother. Ravi felt sad. He decided to help. He planted trees with his grandparents and asked villagers to switch off outdoor lights at night. Months later, the village became greener and quieter. One evening, Ravi saw dozens of fireflies dancing in the dark. "They are back," he shouted happily. Thanks to Ravi's small steps, nature returned to the village. Moral: even one small step to protect nature can bring back its lost beauty. Question 2. Repeat activity 11.4, but this time cover the face of the torch with a colored transparent paper and observe the color of the shadow. Repeat this using transparent paper of different colors. Report your conclusions. Answer, when we cover the torch with blue, red or green transparent sheets, the shadow remains black or dark, but the surrounding light becomes colored. Conclusion, color of the light changes, but shadows stay dark as no light passes through the object. Next question, a plane mirror forms only a single image of an object. But what will happen if two or more mirrors are kept at an angle with each other or parallel to each other? Find out by placing two mirrors as shown in figure 11.21. This one. Answer, when two mirrors are kept at an angle like 60 degree, 90 degree, etc., multiple images are formed. At 90 degree, you can see three images. At smaller angles, even more images appear. This is due to multiple reflections. Next, You are given a small piece of a plane mirror, and this piece forms an image of an object much larger than the mirror, like a large tree. Think and predict, then carry out the activity. Answer: yes, a small mirror can form an image of a large object like a tree. Only the part visible to the mirror is seen in the image. When you change the position of the mirror, different parts of the large object appear. So friends, we have completed all the question answers. From chapter 11, Light, Shadows and Reflections, we have already studied the short notes and summary of this chapter. You can find the link in the description and on the screen. If you like the video, kindly like it and share it with your friends. Also subscribe to my channel. We will meet in the next video. Thank you for watching.